Hi, my name is Reggie Wright. I work for the East Brunswick Police Department, the Community Policing Unit. I've had the pleasure of having 26 cadets this past week for our Junior Police Academy. This past week, we have seen so much and experienced so much. These cadets have an opportunity to visit the New Jersey State Police Aviation Unit. They also had a chance to visit the New Jersey State Police Museum. What a tremendous opportunity for these 26 cadets to just explore various sectors within law enforcement, K-9, the prosecutor's office, the sheriff's department, New Jersey Department of Corrections came in. But what we were looking to do this week was just to give them a glimpse, a little snapshot into what it's like to be part of a traditional police academy. So hopefully over the last week, they've had some great insight in regards to what it's like to be a cadet in a police academy, but what is it like to also be involved in law enforcement. I hope that they were able to enjoy themselves, have fun, but also learn some character traits that would help them become successful men and women in life. Today marks our graduation for Class 15. It's a culmination of everything that has gone over this past week. This is the 15th time that we have done this in the history of East Brunswick Police Department, and we're just excited to have this graduation class here today. Led by Officer Stewart.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order, arms!
Family and friends, you may take your seats. The cadets will now be inspected one last time by Officer Stewart. Police Department's Junior Police Academy. My name is Officer Wright. I've had the pleasure this week of working with the cadets, your children, your child, over the past 5 days. It's been a tremendous honor and privilege. Thank you so much for trusting them with us. It hasn't just been me, though. I've had the pleasure of working with Officer Michael Smith and Officer Stewart as well. They have been a tremendous asset in helping me this past week, and they're a tremendous asset to the East Brunswick Police Department. At this time, I'm going to ask Captain Thomas Keeling to come up to the stage. He just has a couple of remarks that he would like to share with the cadets as we close out the ceremony.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for all being here today. I'd like to start by saying a big congratulations to our cadets. You all put in a lot of time and effort into this week to see it through for its successful completion. In the beginning of the week, I told all of you, I spoke to you briefly, and I told you how the East Brunswick Police Department is regarded as one of the top law enforcement agencies in the state of New Jersey. I explained that this was your opportunity to be part of it, to experience and to see what we do and how we do it. I asked you to come with an open mind, to be respectful and show full attention to your instructors, and you did just that. You should all be very proud of yourselves. I emphasized to you that you only get out what you put in, and you showed that you wanted to be here and that you wanted to learn. It is my hope that we've piqued some of your interests in maybe one day considering a career in law enforcement. In speaking for myself, this was something that I have always wanted to do since the time I was about 4 years old. And not only did I always want to be a police officer, but I specifically wanted to be an East Brunswick police officer. Like you, this is where I grew up, and this is where I continue to raise my family. It's special and it means something to me. Something that I take a lot of pride in. I was determined to reach my goal, and there's no doubt in my mind that with all the hard work that you've shown and continued education, that you're going to reach all the goals that you set out to do as well. I want you to know in the future, do not hesitate to ever reach out to myself or any of the other men and women in this department. We are here for you. I wish you all a very happy and safe rest of your summer. Thank you very much.
At this time, I would like to also welcome to the stage the mayor of East Brunswick himself. He's here in the flesh, everyone. The mayor is here. Mayor Brad Cole.
First of all, I want to thank each and every one of you for contributing your time and your energy to this week of training. I also want to thank the parents and your family that's here to see you through that. I think it's a critical job, a critical training that you got today, whether it's something that you ultimately in time decide to use because you have, like the captain, an interest from an early age in law enforcement. This gives you a little bit of an entry to see what that's really like from the inside, or whether it teaches you how to be a better citizen. Because the safety and the security of a community, while we entrust that to our police and our firefighters and our emergency services, but it's really predicated on us working as a community. It means every single one of us have to be part of keeping everyone else safe. That means being a good observer, learning about how the police process and law enforcement actually works, respecting authority, understanding the fact that there is a chain of command and that process and discipline leads to a process that helps keeping us safe and saves lives. But yet at the same time, we are all still individuals and we have to recognize when people are deviating from what's normal and be able to report that. That's how we keep each and everyone safe. We need to be a community and work together to make sure that we ensure everybody's safety. While it's my role to do that, it's our role to make sure that we provide that security blanket around us, but it's each of us that really makes that successful. So I don't know where the future is going to bring each and every one of you, but I wish you the absolute best, and I thank you, and I thank your parents for allowing us the opportunity to provide you this opportunity to learn about law enforcement. Thanks.
this time, in just a second, not quite yet, just in a second, we're gonna have a slideshow. And what I'd like to do is present some photos from the past week, from the experience that these cadets had. One of the things I emphasized to them was setting reachable goals. That's one of the things I do with the fifth graders in the LEAD curriculum. And I wanted these cadets, even though they're not in the fifth grade, they're between the ages of 13 and 17, besides one, which is a little inside joke that we have. They understand it. But I want them to know that they can reach their goals. And part of our program here at the Junior Police Academy is that we wanted to have a field trip. We wanted to invite some people in so they can get a chance to see that if law enforcement is their goal, maybe they can visualize themselves being in our roles one day, or the roles of the presenters that came in. So please take a few moments and just look at the screen as we look at some of the pictures and reflect on this past week. This time we're going to have the presentation of certificates. I will ask Officer Michael Smith and Captain Thomas Keenley to please come to the stage.
First squad, on your feet. Left face.
Nina Atros. Darian Cheruboga. Leela Serjak. Costa. Nicholas DePass. Destiny Doyle. Sebastian Feigelmuller. Anthony Griffith. Yusuf Gergis. Jessica Hong. Akum Kang. Irina Kulishova. John Mangrino. Advanti Mantina. Elias Payon. Anish Patiola. Matthias Perez. Isabella Rodriguez. Benjamin Savage. Esther Savage. Sayoon Su. Clement Pham. Mira Udani. Gabriel Vasquez. Jayan Vasquez. Anish Yanduri.
At this time, we have two special presentations, awards to give out. One is the Physical Fitness Award. So we wanted the cadets to kind of have a glimpse of what it's like to be in a traditional police academy, and they literally got a glimpse. When I say a glimpse, I mean a glimpse. So I'm not sure what they said when they came home in the evenings, but trust me, we gave them a glimpse. We had 5 days, and I think we did an intro to PT on Monday. We had a physical fitness assessment on Wednesday, and I believe we may have done some on Thursday. It's happened, I'm not sure, I remember. But trust me, it was a glimpse. This gentleman impressed me more than just his physical fitness. On Tuesday, we had a trip to the New Jersey State Police Museum, and while we were there, most of the time the kids were just mingling and speaking amongst themselves. But this gentleman came to me and he asked me a question. And I had kind of spoken to them on Monday, gave them a little glimpse of what I do and what I'm into. And I spoke a little bit about real estate, being a real estate investor. And he came up to me and he asked me some questions in regards to real estate. And I thought that was pretty insightful for him being 16 years old. But then today he even asked me a more impressive question. Where is he at? I want to make eye contact with him. There he is. I'm gonna make eye contact with him. He asked me a question literally about 30 minutes before we got started, maybe an hour before we got started here today. And he said, Officer Wright, he said, can I ask you a question? He said, what drives you and what motivates you? And I thought that was a really good question. What drives me and what motivates me? So this young man, his name is Sebastian. I'm not gonna try to say his last name because I do not want to get it incorrect. But Sebastian is this year's recipient of the Physical Fitness Award. He did an excellent job. Please come to the stage, Sebastian. How do you say your last name? Say it again.
Figo Mueller.
I would have never gotten that right. Congratulations, man. All right, I've been in community policing since the beginning of 2018. And this is my third Junior Police Academy. We missed 2 years, obviously due to the pandemic. And this next award, I think this year was the most difficult. It was extremely difficult, I should say, in terms of choosing a cadet. This is the Instructor's Leadership Award. This candidate was chosen based on their ability to show leadership, not necessarily from what they say to others, but how they carry and conduct themselves. One of the things that's important to me, personally important to us as a police department, is character. How does someone display themselves? How do they carry and conduct themselves? If they left the room and someone said, could you please tell me some traits and how this person models themselves in terms of their discipline, their responsibility, their integrity, so forth and so on. This cadet exemplified this week what it means to be a leader. And sometimes a leader can lead without saying a word. They just lead by their actions. And his name is Matthias Perez. Did I say it right, Matthias? This entire week, Matthias never deviated from the standard. I have a saying that the standard is the standard. And he would always come up to me if he had to go to the restroom and he would stand at attention. And he would say, sir, may I go to the bathroom? Sir, may I ask you a question? Sir, he never deviated from the standard. And for that, I appreciate you. Thank you so much. All right, at this time, once Mr. Perez has his seat, in a second, I'm just gonna say a couple words, and then I'm gonna have the cadets dismissed by Officer Stewart. Again, I just wanna reiterate the six principles that I told you guys. I'm gonna make it very brief, because I know you guys wanna get home with your family and your friends. Just realize that you can reach your goals, whether they're goals that are related to law enforcement, or whatever it is that you set out to do. Set reachable goals. Visualize and picture yourself reaching your goals. Remember, the battle starts where? Where's it start? In the mind. It starts in the mind, right? Say I can rather than I can't. What's the one thing you can't get back?
Time.
You can't get time back. So take advantage of the time that you have. You cannot get this time back. You're at a pivotal point in your age, right? Think about the friends that you choose. I say it all the time, I beat a dead horse. If you show me your friends, I show you your future. All right? Think about the people that you're surrounding and you're hanging around, because they're gonna have a tremendous impact on where you're gonna go. Strive for greatness, right? Have a goal. A goal helps you live a narrow life. Stay focused, stay locked in, all right? Make sure you have a plan. If you fail to plan, you plan to fail, all right? Utilize the gifts and talents that you have been given, all right? Make the most of your life, all right? What I tell you, when people have gifts, talent, ability, and skill, they don't use it, it's unmet potential. So utilize the potential that you have, all right? Yes?
Sir, yes, sir.
All right. At this time, they're going to be dismissed by Officer Stewart.
Class, attention.
Honesty, loyalty, respect.
Dismissed.
Thank you guys for coming out. That is the end of our graduation ceremony. Thank you.